Hello people, my name is Ferdy and in this tutorial I will edit nothing. So this will be one recording, no edits. I want to do different, and if you like this, let me know because I've spent a lot of time editing my videos. What I want to do in this video, I want to show you how you can use ChatGPT to create code snippets for your website. There's a free plugin for WordPress users called Code Snippets, and that can help you to install snippets of code without installing a plugin, which will keep your website faster and more secure. What I want to do, I am working on this website, gamesunited.com, and I want to sell things, but my website is not finished yet. I don't want people to go to my website already and see what I have, because I'm still working on it. It's not finished. Not everything is working. So what I want to do, I want people that are not logged in to be redirected to an external page with an opt-in form. So they can fill in their name and email address. They get discount for the first purchase on my website. And then when people fill in their details, they get a... Now we add it to a list, and when my website goes live, I will stop the redirection to an external landing page and let all the people that fill in their details know, hey, right now my website is live, you can get your discount. And then maybe in my first day of being live with my website, I can already have my first sale. So let me show you how you can do that using code snippets and ChatGPT. I go to the backend of my website, I go to plugins, add new. And if you don't have code snippets yet, you can search for code snippets. It's from the makers Code Snippets Pro. You can install it and activate it. So I go to snippets, all snippets. And by default, there are already four snippets. So I want to create a new one, but I'm not into coding. So what I will do, I will go to chat.openai.com and I will talk to ChatGPT. I just tell them what I have. I will just tell them like it's a person. Hey, ChatGPT, how are you? Hey, ChatGPT, I have a WordPress website and I want non-logged in users. People that are, no, you know what? I want visitors that are not logged in to be redirected to HTTPS. Ferdy.com. I will change that redirection to Ferdy.com later to the omnisend form. Right now, just say Ferdy.com. To be redirected to Ferdy.com, except for people who want to log in to my, to the website through WP admin or WP or login.php. Can you write a PHP code snippet for me that I can implement in my website using the WordPress plugin called Code Snippets. Enter. Bring it on. Okay. I'm not that good in codes, but I think it says a redirection for not logged in users. If people are not logged in, they will go to this URL. Except maybe for WP admin. I hope that's the case. Here's the PHP code snippet you can use with a code snippets plugin to redirect non-logged in users to your desired URL with allowing access to the login pages. Woo! I like it a lot. So I paste it and I say redirect to external page, except when people log in, because I will give this code snippet to people. And what happened is I had a code snippets and those people that are, when they logged out, they could not log in anymore because then they were redirected to the other page. So that's why I make that exception. That's why I like that we can use ChatGPT for that. So let's test it. Save the changes and activate. Then if I go to my website, Games United, I'm logged in. So I go to this website. If I'm not logged in, I open this in an incognito window. I go to Ferdy.com. Voila! C'est ça. C'est le syndicat d'initiative. That's the first word I learned when I had learned French in my class. Let's go to the incognito window again, but this time check it with WP admin. And now we can log in. So I can log in. Voila. This is how it works. So what I can do now, I can go to omnisend.com. I can log in. I like that guy. I met him at WordCamp. Really nice guy. Really creative. I did not meet this guy, but that's okay. Hey, he's alive. So I will go to my forms, and depending on which form I want. So here, discounts. Go over here. There's the page. I copy the page. So I go to the backend of gamesunited.com. I go to snippets, all snippets, redirect to external page, and then I change that URL. Bam. So now when people go to my website, which is not finished yet, they go to my external page and then I say, but I'm the owner of this website, so I want to log in. gamesunited.com/wp-login.php. And then they have access to that website. I love it. My camera is heating up, so I'll leave it with this. Let me know if you like this way of doing tutorials with no cuts at all, because it's taking me a lot of time to cut all the errors. My sister is my editor. I want to fire her, but I want to give her good reason to fire her. She will not see this because she will not edit this video. She's my editor. No, she's doing a great job. For the long tutorials, I will definitely let her edit all the videos. But I'm just wondering what you think of this kind of tutorial without edits. Okay, bye-bye. But wait, there's more. My camera's cooled down again, so I can continue with the tutorial. What if I want to add one more thing? What I want to add is that people go to a landing page or a coming soon page within the website, within gamesunited.com. So not an external page. So let me show you how we can fix that. I say, awesome. Thank you. Of course, we need to be polite to ChatGPT. Otherwise, when they will be there in human forms, they can torture us and we don't want that. We want to be their friends as long as they are in this cage called a computer, a MacBook. I hope Apple will sponsor this video. Okay, let's continue. What I want to have an internal coming soon page. Thank you. What I also want in the PHP code is that people will be redirected to the URL /coming soon. And that coming soon page is also accessible for people that are not logged in. I hope it's enough for ChatGPT to fix the script. Okay. I've updated the code to the redirection non-user. Ensure that the page is accessible without login. Oh, cool. I like ChatGPT. So now I need to create a coming soon page. So real quick, page. Coming soon. I of course, okay, let's have an image. If you see the PlayStation or the PlayStation, and it's accessible, then it means that it works. So I open this in an incognito window. Now I'll be added to the coming soon page. Awesome. Of course, I can get rid of the header and the footer. So I'll keep it with this. Thank you for watching this tutorial again, and have a great day. Bye-bye.